Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at making motion adjustments to your Cartoon Animator animations in iClone, as well as how to animate multiple characters in your scene. Let's start off with this cool looking archery motion. Unfortunately, he doesn't have the same cool hat in iClone though. To start things off, we need to select the character in iClone and open up our Edit Motion Layer tool, which can be found in the Modify panel. This is where we can tweak certain parts of the animation using keyframe editing. Let's ensure that we're on the first frame in iClone, and then we can select different parts of the body and slightly adjust the initial pose at frame 1. Note that we're doing this using IK or Inverse Kinematics mode, which allows the rest of the body parts to follow along with our adjustments of the limbs. We can then switch over to FK for Forward Kinematics mode and move a few frames ahead when our character is taking his first shot, then select different sections of our character's torso and rotate them backwards for a higher shot. We can then go further down the timeline to different parts of the motion and rotate the character forward, and then once more for the third shot. Then we can play back and see the difference. There's also a really cool part in the Edit Motion Layer tool that allows you to clench the fingers simply by clicking and dragging on different areas of the hand. If you click and drag on the palm area, you can close or spread open the fingers by going left or right. If you drag up and down, then the fingers will curl outwards or inwards. You can do this for individual parts of the fingers as well. It's really the best and most accurate way to modify your character's hand gestures. Next, we'll take a look at the Motion Puppet tool, which is also found in the Modify panel. This tool allows us to use our mouse movements to quickly and easily animate our characters using a number of embedded loopable template motions. You can see a couple of them on display here as I preview. There are some for idle, different moods, movements, and talking motions as well. Let's take a look at this sneaky tiptoe looped motion. There are two main sliders for exaggeration and speed that you can adjust to give the motion its own customized tempo and appearance. Beside that on the left are various sliders that correspond to specific parts of the body that allow you to customize even further. We can have our character lean forward a bit and increase the value for bouncing hips to make him go up and down a bit more. Once we're satisfied with our customization, then we can go ahead and record by hitting the record button and pressing the spacebar. Press the spacebar again when you want to stop. Notice that because we didn't have record mode set in the Motion Link plugin, that motion will only record to iClone. If we enable record mode in the Motion Link plugin, then we can send that modified motion to Cartoon Animator. Lastly, let's take a look at how to animate multiple characters at the same time. To learn how to add more characters in Motion Link, check out our Getting Started tutorial. You can see here I already have the scene set up with two dummy characters in Motion Link and two characters in CTA. I'm going to use the E hotkey to bring up my rotation gizmo and then rotate my pink character to face her counterpart. Once I've done that, I'll apply a motion to both characters and play back. You'll see both characters pass by and wave at each other. What we want to do is broadcast this into Cartoon Animator, so let's first select our Roger character and enable Motion Link for his body and hands. Before we preview, we'll also need to set the correct projection angle, which we learned about more in the camera projection tutorial. In this case, I'm going to select a negative 50 degree profile, then go ahead and preview in CTA. It looks like a success, so let's switch over to record mode and record his motion. That's it for Roger, so let's work on our red character now. Let's go ahead and select the other pink dummy first, and essentially, we want to repeat the process. Only now, we're going to make sure Red is all linked up in Motion Live 2D, the same way Roger was, then set to preview mode. Roger will do his motion in CTA since it's already recorded, but we need to set the projection angle for Red first. Let's use the same negative 50 as we did for Roger, and also select Flip Body since she's facing the other way in CTA. The preview looks good, so let's go ahead and enter into record mode. And that's about all there is to it. Just make sure that you have each of your on-screen characters in CTA assigned to a different dummy in iClone, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching, everyone. Make sure to check out our forums over at forum.reillusion.com, and I'll see you in the next video.